You know, I tried to tailor Skybound to be the company that I would want to work at in my Battle Pope days. Weezer's playing. Cool. I guess I'll keep talking to IGN. Hi, IGN. Yes, please watch Walking Dead. It's fantastic. There was one San Diego during that period where I woke up in the middle of the night, flat on my back in my hotel room with my arm extended into the air in front of me, shaking hands with people that weren't there.
You're running Skybound and you do series by other guys, you know, something like Manifest Destiny is one of my personal favorites, but you've got a lot of great books out there. What are you, this is something people watching this would want to know. What are you looking for in Skybound? Is it like, you know, is it the art? Is it something that isn't being done elsewhere? Or is there like, you know, certain things that you're always looking to have like the complete package? What do you look for when you decide, yes, this is a book we want to do?
I mean, it's that intangible thing. I mean, to a certain extent, it is something that isn't really happening anywhere. Like, it's something that's unique. But, I'm looking for books that have that special something where you're like, oh, that's interesting. Like, I'm totally into that. You know, if you look at Birthright, if you look at Manifest Destiny, Outer Darkness, like all of these books have like a some kind of a hook to them where you're like, oh, that's an interesting idea that I really want to, you know, find out more about, which, you know, is a stupid vanilla thing to say, because that's pretty much what everyone's looking for. But I don't know. I mean, I kind of look at Skybound as like, you know, because Image Comics, Image Central has the best deal in town. Skybound does not offer that deal.
Right.
What Skybound does is, yeah, because the partner studios cannot compete with Image Central, so Image Central has to have a better deal. So by design, I can't, you know, offer the same thing that, you know, the Image deal is. And it wouldn't make sense for me to do that because the Image deal is, you know, a completely nutty deal that a business cannot make a profit off of. That's why Image Comics doesn't really, as an entity, make a profit. So, you know, I tried to tailor Skybound to be the company that I would want to work at in my Battle Pope days. You know, when I was doing Battle Pope, like, I would have been thrilled to be working with a company like Skybound because they would have been, you know, like, giving me the financial stability and editorial support and all the different things that I didn't have back then that, you know, ran me ragged to a certain extent. And so I want to be able to find those creators that are doing those cool special books, you know, that need that little, you know, extra little kick. There are a few projects, I won't name what they are, where I'm like, this has no commercial viability whatsoever, but I absolutely love this project, and I feel like it's my duty, because I'm in the position that I'm in, to be able to, you know, help this project exist. Wow. And some of those have ended up being successful and some of them haven't. So you never really know what is actually commercially viable.
Sure.
But, you know, I do, you know, like the fact that I can go, I'm going to make sure this book happens because as a fan, I want this book to happen. And that's kind of fun.
I'd love to wrap up with like just a few questions about like things that are happening today.
Sure.
One thing like is more broad, and that's like, you know, when I met you, you were like renting a booth at places like Wizard World Chicago and stuff like that. Now, you know, I'll tell you this, whenever I go to a convention, well, like a big convention, Image has like the most noticeable pavilion. Half of it looks like just the Robert Kirkman pavilion. But what's it like for you specifically when you go to a convention these days? Is it like very scheduled and regimented, or what's that feel like for you these days?
I mean, yeah, it's very regimented and scheduled. I do less press these days than I did in the recent past. You know, Walking Dead season 1 through season 6 or so, like it was just nonstop. Right. And after a certain point, I was like, at this point, I'm doing press to promote myself, not the show. The show doesn't need promoting, and I don't really care about promoting myself, so I'm doing less press. So things are a little quieter now, thankfully. But yeah, I mean, there were times where, like, at San Diego, like, I would do, like, a radio show interview at, like, 6 in the morning, and then I would have something every hour that I would have maybe like 8 to 10 minutes to get to. And I would like schedule like, okay, well, the convention center, I can do it here. And then this hotel's close, so I'll do that. And then this one's at this place. And then this one's at this place, and this one's at this place, and so I can just move this way. And then we would have like some kind of crazy like Walking Dead party that, you know, is sponsored by a car company, and like we did a party that like Weezer was at, and you know, that seems like the coolest thing in the world, but like that thing involved a press line that I had to be in for like 2 hours, where I was like answering questions while the party was going on, and I was like,
so for you it's still a little bit
Weezer's,
of work.
Weezer's playing, cool. I guess I'll keep talking to IGN. Hi IGN, yes, please watch Walking Dead, it's fantastic. So I worked from like 6 a.m. to like midnight. That was crazy. There was one convention, there was one San Diego during that period where I woke up in the middle of the night, flat on my back in my hotel room with my arm extended into the air in front of me, shaking hands with people that weren't there.
Yeah.
Like I woke up and was like, yeah, no, thank you. No, I really appreciate that. That's, thank you for that. And then I opened my eyes and was like, I'm in my hotel room. What's happening? And then I just went back to sleep. So things got a little crazy there.
Are the fans kind of the same? You know, or has the fandom changed, do you feel like for yourself? Like
I don't think fandom has changed at all. I mean, it's always good. Like, what's interesting is social media and the internet brings out like the nastiest people. So that's when I get the
more
Walking Dead, you fat fuck, you know, that kind of stuff. And so that stuff is a little annoying. But in person at conventions, fans have always been and continue to be the nicest goddamn people you'll ever meet in the world. Like,
yeah.
You know, you can get annoyed because you're like trying to walk in the bathroom and someone's like, hey, can you sign my book? But at the same time,
like with my piss.
No, but I have ticketed signings now because they want to manage the line. So in order to get my autograph, you have to like go to the image booth and get a ticket, and then you have to come back at a set time. And there's only so many tickets to go around. So like that guy that's stopping me on the way to the bathroom is like, has no other choice. And that's a guy that has been dedicated to my work and is reading my books the same as the people that were able to get the ticket. And it's not fair to him that he couldn't get a ticket. He came to San Diego, wanted to get a book signed by me. So I'm always like, open that backpack up, man. Let's totally do this.
That's great.
You know, every now and then it gets to be a bit much, but like, I always have to recognize that, like, you know, like I'm very fortunate to be in the position that I'm in. It's cool
that rarefied
people actually want to get my, yeah. I mean, I'm very aware of the Battle Pope days when I was standing in a booth next to Tony Moore, watching people walk by who didn't give a fuck, like all day long. Hey, would you like to look at me?
Yeah.
And like, that was an 8-hour day at a convention.
Yeah.
So, you know, the fact that, you know, there's people hounding me about stuff is, you know,
that's a good awesome. Problem.
So I'm always open to that kind of stuff.
Yeah, absolutely. And do you use urinals now, or do you still just locking yourself in the toilet stall every time?
I use urinals from time to time.
Whoa.
I was definitely an anti-urinal person because I've always had a problem with splashback, but yeah.
You're a strong guy.
I guess we're talking about this now.
You're a strong guy. No. No, I'd love
maybe
to.
Maybe my urine stream isn't what it used to be in my younger days.
You won't be talking about this with IGN. I hope that this at least is different.
That is true.